Hello, good evening. It's 5:01. I will now call the council.
This meeting is being recorded.
We'll begin. We'll call to order this Tracy City Council meeting for today, the closed session for 5 o'clock PM. Roll call, please.
Councilmember Ariola.
Present.
Councilmember Bedoya.
Here.
Councilmember Evans.
Present.
Mayor Pro Tem Davis.
Present.
And Mayor Young.
Present. Thank you. In accordance with the California Department of Public Health guidelines, universal masking indoors is recommended for all persons regardless of vaccination status. Members of the public can participate in tonight's meeting remotely by visiting the City of Tracy Events webex.webex.com. The information is on your screen right now. You can use the information there to dial in. If you would like to speak on an item, you may press the hand icon to the left of, to the right of your screen, I'm sorry, and then press that same hand icon to lower your hand when you're done. But if you're calling in by phone, you may press *3 in order to raise the hand icon to speak on an item. At this time, we have items from the audience, which are items not on the agenda for this evening. We have a total allotted time for 15 minutes. I see no one inside the chambers here, but let's check on WebEx. Do we have anyone on WebEx wishing to speak on an item that's not on this agenda?
No WebEx.
Thank you. Then we'll bring it back for our next item, which is request to conduct closed session. And this will be done by motion. We have two segments tonight, 4A and 4B. 4A is conference with legal counsel, existing litigation, government code section 54956-90(d)(1). The case title is Mayor Matrakas versus City of Tracy and Sterling Communities LLC. And then 4B is the conference with legal counsel, existing litigation, same legal government code, but this is for Rosebook 58 LLC versus City of Tracy et al.
I move to conduct closed session related to items 4A and 4B.
Second.
It was moved by Councilmember Ariola and seconded by Mayor Pro Tem Davis. Roll call. I'm sorry.
And Mayor, I just want to make note that I will need to recuse myself on item 4A, and I will be doing that until I receive formal advice from the FPPC.
Okay. With that, roll call, please.
Councilmember Ariola?
Yes.
Councilmember Evans?
Yes.
Councilmember Bedoya?
Yes.
Mayor Pro Tem Davis?
Yes.
And Mayor Young.
And before I answer on that, I do apologize. I did not ask for any public comment on these items. Before we go to closed session, do we have, I know the ones inside the chambers here, but do we have anyone on WebEx?
No public comment.
Thank you. Then my answer to that is yes. And so we will be back when we're done with closed session, hopefully before 6 o'clock.
During the January 17th, 2023 regular meeting of the Tracy City Council, the council approved all items on the consent calendar, except for the December 21st, 2022 special meeting minutes. Consent items 1A and 1E were pulled for discussion prior to approval, and Councilmember Evans recused himself from consent item 1G. Under the regular agenda, the council approved item 3A, out-of-state travel for all council members to Washington, D.C. for the 2023 National League of Cities Congressional City Conference, the One Voice trip with the San Joaquin Council of Governments, and Dallas, Texas for the 2023 Public-Private Partnership Conference and Expo. Under regular item 3B, the council appointed Lori Souza and Scott Arbogast to the Parks and Community Services Commission to serve the remainder of two vacated terms beginning on January 18, 2023 and ending on January 31, 2024. Under regular item 3C, the council appointed council members Bedoya and Evans, with council member Areola serving as an alternate, to a subcommittee to interview applicants for the Building Board of Appeals. Under regular item 3D, the council appointed Councilmember Evans and Mayor Pro Tem Davis, with Councilmember Bedoya serving as an alternate, to a subcommittee to interview applicants for the Measure V Residence Oversight Committee. Regular item 3E, a resolution extending the term of the Ad Hoc Fiscal Sustainability Subcommittee, was pulled from the agenda by the city manager and will be brought back at the next meeting. Under regular item 3F, the council reviewed and approved appointments to the following committees, boards, and commissions. Please visit cityoftracy.org to view the meeting agenda, staff reports, and full council meeting video.
So you're ready to recycle your food scraps, but you worry about the ick factor. You can fight climate change and keep your kitchen clean. Just line your kitchen bin with used paper or wash it in between uses. Some containers even come with air filters to keep odors in check, but a bit of baking soda works too. You can also empty your kitchen bin in your curbside container every few days, or you can freeze your kitchen scraps until your curbside collection day. Once outside, layer your food and yard waste to keep your curbside bin clean and give it a quick rinse as needed. If pests weren't a problem when your food scraps went in the trash, moving the material to a new bin should be no different. Check iRecycleSmart.com for more tips and resources to help you join California's climate food fight.
Do your part.
Recycling food scraps is the easiest way that you can fight climate change, and all it takes is a few tweaks to your kitchen routine. If you have the space, a countertop bin for produce scraps, moldy leftovers, coffee grounds, and other kitchen waste is good for families on the go. Bins with filters and airtight lids keep your kitchen fresh between trips to the curbside bin. Under the sink containers are great when space is tight. Plus, the kids can even get involved. And you can always upcycle old containers, store your organic waste in the freezer, and recycle it when you're ready. Check iRecycleSmart.com and join California's climate food fight.
Do your part. Recycle smart.
during the January 17th, 2023 regular meeting of the Tracy City Council, the council approved all items on the consent calendar, except for the December 21st, 2022 special meeting minutes. Consent items 1A and 1E were pulled for discussion prior to approval, and Councilmember Evans recused himself from consent item 1G. Under the regular agenda, the council approved item 3A, out-of-state travel for all council members to Washington, D.C. for the 2023 National League of Cities Congressional City Conference, the One Voice trip with the San Joaquin Council of Governments, and Dallas, Texas for the 2023 Public-Private Partnership Conference and Expo. Under regular item 3B, the council appointed Lori Souza and Scott Arbogast to the Parks and Community Services Commission to serve the remainder of two vacated terms beginning on January 18, 2023 and ending on January 31, 2024. Under regular item 3C, the council appointed council members Bedoya and Evans, with council member Areola serving as an alternate, to a subcommittee to interview applicants for the Building Board of Appeals. Under regular item 3D, the council appointed Councilmember Evans and Mayor Pro Tem Davis, with Councilmember Bedoya serving as an alternate, to a subcommittee to interview applicants for the Measure V Residence Oversight Committee. Regular item 3E, a resolution extending the term of the Ad Hoc Fiscal Sustainability Subcommittee, was pulled from the agenda by the city manager and will be brought back at the next meeting. Under regular item 3F, the council reviewed and approved appointments to the following committees, boards, and commissions. Please visit cityoftracy.org to view the meeting agenda, staff reports, and full council meeting video.
you're ready to recycle your food scraps, but you worry about the ick factor. You can fight climate change and keep your kitchen clean. Just line your kitchen bin with used paper or wash it in between uses. Some containers even come with air filters to keep odors in check, but a bit of baking soda works too. You can also empty your kitchen bin in your curbside container every few days, or you can freeze your kitchen scraps until your curbside collection day. Once outside, layer your food and yard waste to keep your curbside bin clean and give it a quick rinse as needed. If pests weren't a problem when your food scraps went in the trash, moving the material to a new bin should be no different. Check iRecycleSmart.com for more tips and resources to help you join California's climate food fight.
Do your part.
Recycling food scraps is the easiest way that you can fight climate change, and all it takes is a few tweaks to your kitchen routine. If you have the space, a countertop bin for produce scraps, moldy leftovers, coffee grounds, and other kitchen waste is good for families on the go. Bins with filters and airtight lids keep your kitchen fresh between trips to the curbside bin. Under the sink containers are great when space is tight. Plus, the kids can even get involved. And you can always upcycle old containers, store your organic waste in the freezer, and recycle it when you're ready. Check iRecycleSmart.com and join California's climate food fight.
Do your part. Recycle smart.
Thank you for your patience. It's 6:31, and we have been in closed session for item that began at 5 o'clock. And so we actually had two items, item 4A and 4B. We were able to discuss 4A. We did not get to 4B. We will move that to a later date where we will continue with that. And so right now there's no reportable action, correct?
Yes, Mayor, no reportable actions.
Thank you. Then at that time, we will convene. We're reconvening to open sessions at this time at 6:32. We already no report action. And so we have council items and comments. We also have that. I'm sorry. Choked up here. We also have that at the next council meeting that was supposed to start at 6. So I'm going to ask any council members, do we have any council items that we need to do now, or can we wait till after this item? Okay. So is anyone else that has council items for this meeting? Okay, then we'll wait to the following meeting for the next, but we'll go ahead. Councilmember Vadola asked to speak at this meeting for council items.
Thank you, Mayor. I'm going to make my council items now. Today being a special meeting, I have a basketball team that I coach a little bit later on today, so I'll stay as long as I can. I'd want to report on a meeting that we had as the Latino Caucus's representative for Cal Cities on the Transportation, Communication, and Public Works Committee. I attended, as well as City Manager Rogers, where we adopted the committee's 2023 work plan based on support for our water grid, transit funding, local street and roads, maintenance and bridge repair and replacement, as well as disaster emergency preparedness and response, and electrical vehicle charging stations. There was also a vibrant conversation had on the topic of purple pipe, which is regarding recycled water in our city and how we can use that for new and old development or existing development. I did want to share two items in regards to two articles published by the Tracy Press. I don't have the exact dates on my mind, but one was the vote for the mayor pro tem position, and another one was the votes for the committee positions. I feel the need to clarify this because the reporting was not in line with the council minutes. Right.
I'm gonna ask for no kind of reactions, please.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you. In this case, the mayor pro tem nomination was characterized as something that I made, without regard, and really that, I'll go ahead and say my comments for after the meeting. That's all I have for now, Mayor. Thank you.
Thank you. At this time, I would entertain a motion for adjournment.
Move to adjourn closed session.
Second.
It was moved by Councilmember Arreola, seconded by Councilmember Evans for adjournment. Roll call, please.
Councilmember Arreola?
Yes.
Councilmember Bedoya?
Yes.
Sorry, Councilmember Evans?
Yes.
Mayor Pro Tem Davis?
Yes.
And Mayor Young?
Yes. Thank you. That concludes the closed session, and now we will move to our special City Council meeting today. That closed. That one is 6:35. And so thank you all for joining us for the Tracy City Council special meeting today, January the 30th at 6 o'clock p.m., technically 6:35. Roll call, please.
Councilmember Arreola?
Present.
Councilmember Bedoya?
Here.
Councilmember Evans?
Present.
Mayor Pro Tem Davis?
Present.
And Mayor Young?
Present. Real quickly, have a little announcement. In accordance with the California Department of Public Health guidelines, universal masking indoors is recommended for all persons regardless of vaccination status. Members of the public can participate in tonight's meeting in person or remotely by visiting the City of Tracy events.webex information that's on your screen at this time. If you'd like to raise your hand to speak on an item, if you're online, please press the hand icon to the right of your screen, and when you're done, press the same hand icon to lower your hand. If you are calling in by phone, the number is there. And if you would like to speak on an item, please press *3, and then that will notify us that you would like to speak on an item. At this time, we have items from the audience. This is a 15-minute time period that we allow for items that are not on the agenda this evening. If you would like to speak, you will have, actually there will be another opportunity. Normally, it's another opportunity. I just want to just double check on here. No, we don't actually have it on this council item. So for this special meeting, if you would like to speak, there's a 15-minute allotted time that we have for that. But since this is the only time, I just need to know how many would like to speak on an item that is not on the agenda this evening. So that's at this particular time. So I see one hand raised. Any other hands inside the chambers? Okay. So with that, what about on WebEx? Do we have any hands raised for items from the audience?
I have one hand.
Okay. So let's go ahead and go on WebEx, and then we'll come back to you, ma'am.
I'm sorry. I have two hands.
Two hands. Okay. Can you just verify these are for items that's not on the agenda? This is for, it's only one thing on the agenda regarding the flag raising today. But if it's for another item, that's fine. So who's, let's go ahead and go with the first caller.
Carol Moore, I'm Mabel Josephine. I come to you tonight because the new council is operating different than in all the years I've been in Tracy. I don't know what's going on, but here's what I saw, and I'd like to hopefully see some change. In the past, when an item, agenda item comes on, there would be discussion first for amongst the council and some discussion from the public, and then eventually a motion would be brought up, and then a second and a vote. But it felt like in the last few meetings, it's just not a lot of discussion. We don't know why anyone's voting, which way they are. It's just a quick motion, second, and now you got to vote, you got to vote, you got to vote. And it's like there's not the understanding of the votes. And so I think the transparency, we're becoming less transparent with this new city council. And I'm just asking for you to go back to the way you did, where you had discussions about why you were making votes and asking questions and making sure that we understand how this council is voting. Because right now, I'm confused, and I think I'm probably not the only one. It sounds like I didn't read the Tracy Press, so I don't know what their comments were. But it sounds like I'm not the only one. So that's all I had. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Moore. Who's next?
Go ahead, caller.
Hello? Hello? Yes, I think I raised my hand at the wrong time. I'm trying to make comments regarding the flying of the Pan-African flag.
All right, thank you. We'll come back to you then when we make sure you raise your hand again for that item. Do we have any other ones on WebEx with their hands raised for items not on the agenda?
No more.
Thank you. Then we'll come back to the audience. We had one hand raised in the audience. Can I just double check? Has anyone else decided that they would like to speak on this? We had a couple of people walk in on items not on the agenda. Okay, then we'll have the one here. If you would give your name, at least.
My name is Gabriela Rodriguez Machuca. I'm the owner of Johnny's Diner in Creamery, along with my husband. On October 18th of 2022, I spoke during items from the audience requesting an amending the mobile food ordinance. After I spoke, I sat down. I was approached by a staff member asking if I would like to speak further. He told me he was a director of development services, which now has retired, sadly. I told him I was here tonight specifically about that mobile food ordinance. However, I did have other concerns. He said, please allow me to help, and I hesitated for fear of retaliation. If you speak up about injustices or you question the process, you fear retaliation. Well, I chose to speak up, and since that day, my husband, myself, and my business have felt retaliation and harassment from some of the city staff. The most recent red tape is today. I've been in the restaurant business here in Tracy in San Joaquin County for 15 years, and I had a brick and mortar, and I served as a commissary for a food truck with no extra approvals from the city. But for me, now that I only currently have a food trailer, I need to seek special approval from the City Development Services Department to see if they will allow and approve the land used to existing operating restaurants to serve as my commissary. That's per the Health Department, per the Development Services of Tracy. I asked, where is that condition listed? I asked, where is the form that grants this land use? It's not online. Well, right before this meeting at 4:45, I stopped at the DES counter, spoke to a planner, and his response is, that's not our job to determine the commissary that that the health department is saying. That's the health department's job. He says, I've never done this before for anyone. I looked at him and I said, I know that. Because I've been here for 15 years in this county in food service, and I'm familiar with all the requirements. However, someone in this office, meaning development services, wants me to come in here and face red tape. The planner wrote down the addresses that I had written down to get approved as land use available. And so he says tomorrow he will, he was gonna email the health department and let them know. But this needs to stop. It's called harassment. Okay. Also, some of the things that I opposed to the development director back in October is, I was asking questions. Why do I need architectural drawings if what I'm doing is not a building, I'm not building a structure? I also asked questions about the TUP, which is called the temporary use permit process, that a food truck needs to get in order to be at a semi-permanent spot. Why is it that we are being held to a higher standard than other businesses in the same district? Has nothing to do with fire safety. They're making us, they're asking for requirements for parking when in the central business district there are no restrictions. They're asking us to provide 4 bathrooms when a lot of the places downtown only have 1. So they want us to provide more for some reason. We're being held to a higher standard. Some of the verbal comments that I've had over the last few weeks are, I'm just the messenger. Management has advised me to do this. Your restaurant does not meet the city guidelines for a restaurant. I asked, where are these guidelines listed? A comment that a staff member said to me is, you shouldn't be taking the stance you're taking. They said that twice to me. It's like, what does that mean? You know, to me, it feels like they're telling me not to speak up, not to say what I'm doing. I wanted to show you that these are all my notes, emails, notes, as of October 2nd, 2022 to today. And this is only half of what we've been experiencing. The issues are, there is a long list. Some of you have gotten some of my emails. And I hope that when I send you an email in it tomorrow, that maybe you'll just take a look at it and maybe hopefully you can help address some of these problems that we're having. Thank you.
Thank you. With that, we will close out public comments, actually items from the audience. And that will take us to Gabriella, I'm sorry, I know you had a 2 last name thing, so I would call you by your last name, but I didn't get that. Okay, Pachuca, our city manager is right there to get your attention to help you from there. Thank you. Okay, thank you. So at this time, we have 1 item up for discussion tonight, which is item 2A. 2A is to adopt a resolution authorizing, number 1, the display of the Pan-African flag in honor of Black History Month on the city flagpole located outside of City Hall for the month of February each year. Number 2, use of city resources to conduct a one-time flag ceremony on February the 1st, 2023. And number 3, waiver of the requirements set forth in section 2.3.1 of the City of Tracy flag policy that requests be made by May 1st of each year as related to the foregoing actions. We'll have a staff report by Midori Lightwork, one of our assistant city managers.
Mayor. Right, sorry. May I ask you a quick question? So I want to ask something, and it's because I meant to say it earlier. I got distracted from the audience, but I wanted to respectfully ask if you would consider moving items from the council before the regular items, as I have a prior commitment.
All right. Okay, so I would ask the council if we would approve for us to go ahead. I'm okay with moving to pause, but not take all council items. If there's any others, I'll ask if we can take that in two sections. Is that possible? Whereas our council member can have his comments before he needs to leave. And if any of the council has council items, we can reserve that for after the item. I just don't know the technical way.
Yeah, Mayor. So just so I'm clear, you're asking just for the item to be partially moved up front to allow one council member to speak.
Yes.
That's okay. You have the authority under the as a presiding chair.
Okay, since you have to leave, I will open up the opportunity for you to do that now, and then rest of the council, if we have any items, if we could do it at the end, okay?
Thank you, Mayor. I appreciate it. For the, in observance of time today, I will reserve my comments directed at the Tracy Press for a regular meeting. I did want to ask if, I want to make a motion that would allow me to amend the acceptance of the 16 acres of land to a later meeting. I move to amend my prior motion that the acceptance of the 16 acres be moved from February 7, 2023 to a meeting before the next case management conference on April 12, 2023.
So would it need to be amended by the person who made the second, be by the person who made the original second on that? Or does it matter?
It could be any seconder.
I think any second would work as long as the original party who made the motion made the same motion. Okay. But there does need to be a second.
Apologize, Council Member. I didn't realize we could make motions during comments, but can you read that one more time?
Yes, sorry. Just another way to say requesting support for a council item. This is in respect to the council item that was made about a month ago to accept the 16 acres of land based on the offer of dedication. And I wanted to ask that they be moved from on or before February 7th to a meeting before the next case management conference on April 12th.
Second.
Thank you, council member.
So just to be clear, that this is for council support for the acceptance. From
correct.
February 7th to a meeting prior to the April, I'm sorry, what is it termed again?
Case management conference.
Case management conference.
Yeah. Just give staff more time to, get more information
okay.
to council and the public. Just wanted to address the reason I'm asking for council items to be moved up today. I coach a youth basketball team today at North School. Wanted to congratulate that team. This past Saturday, we had our first win, hopefully one of many. We're still working on our team name, but it's under the Junior Warriors League for the city. Next time around, if there's anyone interested, it's a great program, gets people involved in the game of basketball. And I will stay as long as I can for this meeting. Preemptively, I do want to say I state my support for the item, but let's see how far we can get. Thank you.
Okay, so then that takes us to, I read it already, so do I need to read it again? I got it. Okay, so I'll turn it over to Midori Lightwork for the staff report.
Thank you, Mayor. Good evening, Mayor, council members. The item before you is a council item, but I'll read the executive summary to give a little bit of context and history for the audience as well as our council members. On June of 2019, the city established a flag policy which was last updated by Resolution 2021-052. It outlines the city's practice on display of flags at city facilities. Section 2.3.1 of the flag policy requires that a request to display a commemorative flag must be made by city council members by May 1st of every year, and that such flag request must be approved by adoption of a resolution with a supermajority or 4/5 vote. In addition, Section 2.3.5 of the flag policy requires that council members seeking to request a flag ceremony must make the request concurrently with the request to display the commemorative flag. On January 19, 2021, the City Council adopted Resolution 2021-008, which authorized the display of the Pan-African flag on the city flagpole located in front of City Hall from February 1st to March 1st of 2021. In May 2021, the City Council authorized several commemorative flags for annual display. The Pan-African flag was inadvertently omitted from the list. Upon learning of this oversight, Mayor Young made a request for the City Council to authorize the display for the month of January each year, the Pan-African flag. In addition, Mayor Young has requested the City Council to authorize a one-time flag ceremony to occur on February 1st, 2023. I turn that back over to Council.
Thank you. I just want to point out the Pan-African flag was the one that was not included in the request specifically for Black History Month. It was included at the same time for the request. It was a brand new request for Juneteenth. So I think kind of like it might get a little bit confused as far as the analysis. I know you just read that part.
I think the Pan-African flag was requested and approved for flying in February of 2021. And each year, just prior to May, you'll get an email from staff that asks for any new requests so that we bring it to council at a May meeting where we ask you for any new requests or for the coming fiscal year. So whether that's ordering new flags or to fly any of the flags that have been requested. In 2021, what we did was went back and said, we understand that it is we had heard that it was the impression of the council that the flags that had been approved up to that point they thought would be flying annually. So we wanted to go back and clarify that it was not specifically for 1 year, but that they wanted their particular flags flown annually. So we cleared those up. But the Pan-African flag was not included in that list in that May 2021. So that's where it was.
The Pan-African flag specifically, though, for Black History Month, because it was included, though, on Juneteenth in that particular meeting. That's what I'm saying.
I see.
So it was listed on there. And sometimes I think just two things, it's two in one, kind of, I'm just kind of, that's maybe inadvertently got missed. So I just wanted to clarify, last year, May of 2022, did we address the flags at all?
I don't recall coming back to council if we didn't have any new requests.
We did not. So that's why it did not come back last year, because it was inadvertently left out because we didn't know that there was any flags for us to address in 2022, correct? But then now we're here because now we just learned recently last week that there was no resolution on file for the Black History Month for the flag to be raised for this year and in and going forward, just as all the other flags have been. So with that, do we have any other clarifying questions from our council? Okay, so with that, we will open up to comments from the audience, public comment on this particular item. So I need to put back on my glasses, sorry. So I can see by a showing of hands, who would like to speak on this item? Okay, I need you to keep them held up so then I can count. Okay, so on this side, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 on this side. And then on this side, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then on WebEx, I know we had one, but do we have any more raised on WebEx?
I have 4 hands raised so far, and I have 6 speaker cards too.
From WebEx, so that would be 16. And I forgot what number it is, but I think it's somewhere around 11, 13. After that, then we limit it less than 5 minutes. So I'm going to ask, I know we have 16 people that have asked to speak. And so if you want to come together as a group, you can have more time. But if you want to come individually, I'm going to ask if we can just keep it to 2 minutes. I would like to try to have all the council here to be able to hear the item if possible. So with 2 minutes on the clock, let's start with the 6 speaker cards out of respect for those who turned those in. And then we will go to WebEx, close out WebEx, and then come back to the council inside the chambers. Okay? So let's start with the 6.
Bobby Bivens?
Good evening, Mayor and Council. I brought a prop with me in case some of the council people didn't know what the Pan-African flag looked like. And the flag, what it represents, and the red is there for the blood of the people. The black is representative of the people, and the green is for the land that we came from and the land that we've worked here in America. So I want to say that it's important that we recognize that the work that African Americans have done and the value that we brought to America and making sure that this is the wealthiest country in the world. African American people did the work of building America for free as slaves. We were brought here as slaves. We're the only people that have come to this continent, this country, to be the benefit of the country, not to come and get the benefit of the country. I would say that almost all of you, other than the two ladies that have come to America through your ancestors, you came here to get the benefits that America had to offer. We put in place those benefits. As a matter of respect and courtesy, we ask, and I represent the NAACP, Stockton branch serving San Joaquin. So it's important that you know who I'm representing. And that we do ask you to fly the flag during Black History Month. Black History Month was declared a month-long recognition of African American people in 1976 by President Gerald Ford. This is a national recognition, not just a community recognition. We are the only group of people that have a flag that is unified for us in this country to give us recognition. We ask that you consider and implement the policy
Excuse
to fly
me,
the flag.
Your time is
starting
up.
Starting February 1st.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Who's next on our speaker's card? Speaker card, next speaker card.
Amini Alexander.
Good evening, Mayor. Good evening, council members. I'm here tonight to urge you to support a waiver for this resolution. It is very important, I think, for our city to bring our city together in one aspect of another. There are seven other organizations on this that were approved. If you leave off this flag for African Americans, I think you're doing a disservice to one part of the city. And you're also setting a precedent for the future. For each one of the other groups that come on, because the new council that comes on here will take a look at this and say, you know what, we don't need to approve any other groups. We can eliminate them. So I'm urging you to look at the fact that African-American flag, the Pan-African-American flag should be a symbol that should be represented like every other flag in this on this one day. I think it's only presented for 24 hours. So it's not that big of an issue, unless you know you feel that it shouldn't be. I hope that you strongly consider it. I don't have much else to say to you, but I ask that you urge that you sincerely support and approve this waiver. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Alexander. Who's next on the cards?
June Yesimski.
Good evening, council members.
Can you pull the mic down a little bit more?
A little bit more?
Yes.
How's that?
Okay, that's better.
Why is it important to adopt a resolution authorizing the display of the Pan-African flag in honor of Black History Month on our city flagpole for the month of February each year? In order to understand the significance of this question, you need to look at history. The creation of the Pan-African flag was a response to an extremely offensive song heard in the year 1900. 123 years ago, that mocked the movement or scattering of a people away from their established ancestral homeland. One of the lines in the song goes, quote, every race has a flag except for the blank. I'm pretty sure you can imagine the word used that I choose not to repeat. This was 40 years after emancipation, when many white people didn't even consider Black people full citizens of the United States or any country for that matter. It is written that the creation of a flag was a step for Black people around the world to claim an identity in their own right. Michael Hanchard, a professor of Africana Studies at the University of Pennsylvania, says that flags are important because they symbolize the union of governance, governance, people, and territory. I want to repeat that. Flags symbolize the union, the coming together of governance, people, and land, territory. Flags represent unity, not division. Choosing to fly the Pan-African flag in Tracy would not only constitute a visual representation of our values, but it sends an important message to everyone, everyone living here, everyone thinking about living here, visitors to our city, and people who are making decisions about possibly cultivating business relationships here in Tracy. The message is that you belong here. What is more unifying than that? I want to live in a city that demonstrates these values. Thank you.
Thank you. Who's next?
Melbourne Lagasca.
Thank you, Mayor Young. My name is Mel Lagasca, and I live at 1034 McKenna Court. Been here for 45 years, and to me, the flag symbolizes much more than Black History Month. Ever since the Civil War, Black Americans have served in every branch of the service. And when I look at your ceremonial flags, it looks like every branch of the service is listed here. And if you go into each one of those branches, you'll see African Americans serving at all levels, from generals down to enlisted people. So the flag is much more than a Black History Month. It's a symbolism of American history, period. It's not just a one-month shot. It's something that generations and generations of Black Americans, of African Americans, have contributed to this society, not only Tracy, but also not just the military, but in politics, our 44th president, an African American president, our current Vice President, African American, contributing to this society, showing their talent. Dr. Corbett, you may or may not know, a black scientist developed the Moderna vaccine for the United States of America. But we can go on and on, but thank you, council members and staff, for the opportunity to speak. Thank you.
Thank you. Who's next on the cards?
Richard Boss.
Okay, Richard Boss.
Mayor Nancy and Council, I'm Richard Boss. I support this motion on personal reasons. I was born and raised in a racist, segregated town here in California. But by the grace of God, I didn't become a racist. And I knew I was a privileged white man. But it wasn't until I met my current wife, who happens to be African American, that I really began studying Black history in America. And I really discovered how privileged I am. And I thought, what can I do to spread this message of equality? And the only thing I could think of is I have to speak to other white people that this is the way it is, and you need to know this. And so I see this flag as a symbol being raised that we can say, look, this is the way it was, and this is what we need to do about it. So I support the raising of the flag. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Voss. Who's the last speaker card that we have?
Yolanda Barrel Knight.
Hello, good evening, everyone. My name is Yolanda Burial Knight, and I come before you as a member of the Tracy African American Association, the Democratic Club, and the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, to state that I approve the resolution which is set forth today, which authorizing the display of the Pan-African flag in honor of Black History Month for the month of February annually. Use of the city's resources for a one-time flag ceremony to honor Evelyn Tolbert, the first Black member of the Tracy City Council, that is currently scheduled for this Wednesday, February the 1st, and the first day of Black History Month, which is the first day of Black History Month, and to request that there be a waiver of the annual May request to the flag policy. I recall when this resolution was first brought to the council some years ago, it had an omission to the resolution. I believe it was missing either Pan-African or Black history, and I know that because I caught it, and I brought it to the city clerk's attention. As a clerk myself, the thing that I speak to my staff about the most is version control of a document. As a clerk since 2015, every now and then the board has had to adopt an amendment to cure for that. Either it has been grammatical, dollar amount, adding or leaving out of zeros, or typo. As long as it does not substantively affect the action, in this case, it is amended. In reading the policy, it states that it requires a four-fifths vote. I have listened to some of the city council proceedings on this flag topic and have been taken aback by the language used as if flying flags for people of a protected class takes away from flying flags in honor of the fallen, the military, or those who work for the city. As we sit here, we all represent your constituents, the voters, the citizens, and friends of many of you on the council, and we ask that you support this amendment. If not for us, for your own city council member, Evelyn Tolbert, who has paved the way for many of the people
Excuse
of color
me, Ms. Knight,
to have the
up.
Seat that you have right
Thank
now.
You.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was the last of our cards, right? How many do we have online? Was it four?
Yes.
Okay, so let's go ahead, if you don't mind, if we can just do the four online real quick, and then we'll come back to inside.
Good evening, council members. My name is Karen Moore, and I'm...
Ms. Moore?
Good evening, City Council. My name is Karen Moore. I'm also in support of rectifying this oversight and making sure that we do fly this flag as we have done in the past going forward. Thank you.
Thank you. Next online.
Go ahead, Mr. Atwell.
Yeah, good evening, council members, city staff, fellow citizens. My name is Gurtej Atwell. So history doesn't stay behind us. Commemorating history helps us understand how the events in the past made things the way they are today. So we not only learn about ourselves, but also develop the ability to avoid mistakes and create better paths for our society. I support and urge your support for Pan-African flag in honor of Black History Month at Tracy City Hall for the month of February each year. As well, the agenda item on page 3, it states that there's no fiscal impact related to this item, so administrative costs will be absorbed in the same budget. As well, the city staff in their report, they also clarified that in May 2021, City Council approved the request for 3 flags to be displayed, but Pan-African flag, it was missed to be mentioned in that agenda item. So including the Pan-African flag will solidify our city's vision towards inclusiveness. So let's take this opportunity to embrace and honor diversity as our strength. Thank you.
Thank you. Who's next online?
This one.
Are we having technical difficulty?
We are having technical issues. They're not unmuting. Maybe you would want to go into the audience and I'll try. Hello? I'll hold it. Here we go.
Okay.
Go ahead, caller.
Yes. Hello. Good evening, council members and mayor. This is Victor Silva. I'm a 67-year-old senior citizen, Hispanic American. I stand for unity and solidarity. And tomorrow is a great opportunity for us to celebrate the Black Americans who have contributed greatly to American history in politics, sports, entertainment, education, and they've even died for this country. So this is a time for change because, quite frankly, I'm tired of driving by government buildings and seeing the U.S. flag at half-mast. I'm tired of the divisiveness that we're seeing in America today. I'm tired of the anger that is causing an attack at our equality and inalienable rights. So it's time to make a positive change for solidarity, so we can join many other cities displaying the Pan-African flag to commence Black History Month, and also unity to show the world that we are a United States of America. So therefore, I ask that you become American heroes today by approving the amendment to allow the display of the Pan-African flag in the ceremony. It's the right thing to do to unite us for liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Silva. We have one more person online.
Go ahead, Lisa.
Adrian. Good evening, Council. This is Lisa Ross, and I also am echoing the request this evening from the audience that demonstrate their unanimous support for approving not only this gesture of solidarity and appreciation for African American history, as well as the respect and courtesy, the solidarity, but also the celebration of our first African Americans elected in Tracy as council member, as mentioned previously, Evelyn Tolbert, as well as yourself, Mayor Young, and also too, that we have our first African American chief of police in Chief Siku Millington. So thank you very much. I anticipate that this will be an easy vote for all of the council to support, because it is the right thing to do, as Mr. Silva has already mentioned, as others have also. So thank you, and I'll look forward to the vote.
Thank you, Ms. Rock. Before we close out, WebEx, I want to just make sure, was any other hands raised in WebEx?
No more hands raised.
All right, thank you. Then we'll resume back to inside the chambers here. So whoever would like to go next. Okay, well, we have a pastor coming, and then after pastor, then we have a...
Good evening, Council. My name is Kevin James, Senior Pastor of New Creation Bible Fellowship here in Tracy. I've been a resident of Tracy since 2004. Our church is a service provider for the city as part of the Mayor's Community Support Youth Support Network. And since my involvement since 2007, it has been our city's focus to affirm all people groups and strive for inclusion. Black History Month is a time to honor the contributions and legacy of African Americans across this U.S. history and society. Excluding the Pan-American flag is just not right. Also, to require someone to request to display the flag each year while others are not. This does not communicate appreciation for what African Americans have contributed to this country. May 2021, Council authorized several flags for annual display, and the Pan-African flag was inadvertently omitted from this list. You know, in professional football and on basketball, when there's a questionable call, there's an opportunity to review that play in order to make the right call. Tonight, this city council has the opportunity to get right the wrong that occurred back in May of 2021. I appeal to you this evening, council, to do the right thing. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pastor James.
Good evening, Honorable Mayor, City Council. It's a pleasure to be here. I want to say that as a Latina and Latina community advocate, I want to say that hopefully we can go back to the right that was done, an omission, an error that was done by whoever. It doesn't matter. Let's bring this community together. Let's do the right thing. Let's, in solidarity, bring all the minorities that we have the challenges and the opportunity to showcase the trailblazer people that they have been here in Tracy. This is an opportunity to celebrate the diversity of our town and to once again correct an error that was done by omitting this flag in this ceremony. I wish I could be here on February 1st. I'm sorry I'm going to miss it, but I'm sure that this council will work together to bring our community together. We need that today more than ever. I have hope and faith that all of you will do the right thing for our community. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Ms. Vargas. And, okay, so we're well, you're right here. We're starting to form a line, but... So to make it easier, I know we have a few more people. If you would, if you don't mind standing, if you can get in line so that we can see and make sure that we're calling everybody. I know we don't usually do it like this, but okay, go ahead. Ms. Bivens.
To Mayor Nancy Young and all of the members of the Tracy City Council, good evening. My name is Luana Johnson Bivens, and I am president of Mu Zeta Omega chapter of Alpha Kappa. Alpha Sorority Incorporated, the oldest African-American sorority, which represents educated women, black women. I'm here this evening to urge your celebration and inclusion of Black History Month and the raising of the Pan-African flag. You know, we've heard so many voices this evening, and I hope that you are truly listening, because we talk about the importance of diversity and inclusion, but we need to walk the talk and include the raising of the Pan-African flag, because it is so important that we celebrate Black History Month, which provides an opportunity to gain a deeper understanding of our history. And I'm so proud that former City Councilwoman Evelyn Tobert will be celebrated. So I urge you to please vote to include the raising of the Pan-African flag this year and every year. Thank you.
Good evening, Council, the Mayor. My name is Chris Cannon. I'm a member of Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated, and I'm also a program manager with Public Health Advocates. As many have said before me, I'm in full support of the flag being raised. As they stated before, this issue doesn't have a fiscal significant impact, so it doesn't cost anything for us to do it. But I think that if we don't do it, it will cost us mental health issues, right? We want to be inclusive in this racial climate that we're in today instead of exclusive. So with that being said, I don't want to take too much of my time. I'm just in full support of raising the flag and passing that motion. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, City Council members, Mayor. Mm-hmm. My name is Gwendolyn White. I am the president of the Tracy African American Association. And I would just like to say right off, I was born and raised in Columbus, Ohio, 1954, in a segregated neighborhood, and I didn't even know it, because I had no flag, I had no sign of any kind of that. I got up every day, went to school, and I said a Pledge of Allegiance to the American flag, because that was what I knew. It wasn't until 2020 that it dawned on me, and I realized, because of history, that I was in a segregated neighborhood. I was forced to do what they told me to do to stay alive. The children here need to know that the Pan-American flag, that they belong, that they did what was necessary to get this country going. You know, this is just California, but we are on the news. It goes further than just Tracy, California. It goes to Columbus, Ohio, where I live, because that's where I come from. We have homelessness, we have battered women, we have drug addiction, we have burglaries, gunshot wound, teenage pregnancy, trafficking, sexual trafficking of young boys and girls, discrimination, running rampant. And we're here talking about a flag. I think it's a waste of time. I think there's a lot that you could be doing, each one of you. You're all voted in by the people here. And I just think there's more that we could be doing, that you could be doing. So for the sake of solidarity, I say fly the flag. Let freedom ring. We've got better things to do. Thank you.
Good evening, Mayor Young, council members. My name is Elizabeth Baker, and I stand before you representing Delta Sigma Theta Sorority, Incorporated. I am the chapter president for the Tracy Area Alumni Chapter, and we service seven cities within San Joaquin and Stanislaus County. And I don't have anything more to add other than, because there's been some really great presentations tonight, that I think that the symbol of the flag, specifically for our children, will make a huge difference. We know that there is a systemic process in place to remove Black history from the schools through books, etc. And this is an opportunity for the city of Tracy to tell our children that you matter, that your race matters. History is real, and that while it may not be taught in school, we have an opportunity to bring it forth and do something from a citywide perspective. We're going to have a ceremony on the 1st where we'll be recognizing affluent or prominent African Americans in the city of Tracy. That's just one part of history of Tracy. But let's do better. Let's do better than those who are trying to suppress us in the school systems with the knowledge that our children need to know. And let's just fly the flag so that they have a sense of pride. I think the kids are being beaten up enough. Let's do something positive for them and stand together as a united States of Tracy in America. Thank you.
Thank you. I just want to make sure this is our last speaker, right? So anyone else? I want to just make sure if anyone else wanted to speak. Okay, because after you finish, then we're going to close it out. All right, go ahead.
Well, first of all, I want to say thank you for even having this on the ballot. My name is Ron Tate. I am the new African-American president for the Chamber of Commerce in Stockton. I lived in Tracy for a while before I moved to Stockton. The city of Tracy is a gateway city, right? It's the city that everybody passes coming to and from the Bay Area, that people live here, but they don't live here. Right, so they really don't understand the significance, because culturally, Tracy is a melting pot, kind of like what the East Coast was when we first started back in the early 1900s. We have an opportunity to create a standard, right? Because standardization is kind of what the world is becoming. Everything is becoming something that everyone else wants to strive to be like. This is an opportunity to create that narrative for different cultures who don't understand. They'll get to see this as they walk by, as they drive by, who didn't come from this country. So this is an opportunity, as we raise this flag, for others to say, what is that? Which creates what? Conversation. Which creates continual conversation from the young to the old who don't come from here, who don't understand our culture. So as you guys think about what you guys want to do when, as it applies to this movement, I'm calling it a movement because that's what it is when we create a standard. I deal in information technology. My background is in computer science. It is not cultural. It is not political. It is science and information. And that's what this is for our children going forward and the people who are moving here from other countries and other locations that are going to see this and understand what this actually represents. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Tate. Mr. Rivers, did you not speak already?
Actually, Madam Mayor, if I can, it's about this, but it's not about the flag. It's about the fact that we're here talking about culture, we're talking about respect, we're talking about acknowledgement of African American people. And I happen to be not too happy with the fact that your city attorney is not in here to understand what we're talking about. That your city attorney, the one that makes policy or analyzes policy on the behalf of the city on such an important matter, is not in this room. And she appears to me, and I could be totally wrong, not to be a person of African American descent. And perhaps she needs to come in here or be in here and get an education herself. But I just wanted to bring that to the table.
Thank you, Miss. Thank you, Mr. Bezos.
It's visible. Thank you.
Thank you. So with that, I'm going to close out. We're going to close out public comment for this evening. I think that it is important to probably note that, which I didn't even realize that Ms. Patel had stopped out, had stepped out. But because it was a note that her office caught, that hence is why we're here today for a special meeting to rectify this. I think it would have been important to have been here at the same time to hear. But fortunately, it's recorded, so she has an opportunity to look at it later. With that, though, we're going to bring it back to the council, and I will open it up for discussion or a motion and then discussion. Actually, it's really set for a motion and then discussion.
Mayor, may I?
Yes. I'm sorry.
Voices. No problem. If someone else would like to make the motion, I will gladly yield. But I'm pressured for time, and I'm hoping that we can
Go ahead.
Get to a motion and discussion as soon as possible. If someone else wants to make the motion, please feel free. If not, I will. Okay. I move to adopt a resolution authorizing, number one, the display of the Pan-African flag in honor of Black History Month of the city flagpole located outside of City Hall for the month of February each year. Number two, use of city resources to conduct a one-time flag ceremony on February 1st, 2023. And number three, to waive the requirement set forth in section 2.3.1 of the City of Tracy flag policy that requests be made by May 1st of each year as related to the foregoing actions.
Second.
It was moved by Councilmember Dola, seconded by Mayor Pro Tem Davis. Sorry, I got to get used to that. And do we have any further discussion? Councilmember Ayala, you have discussion.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. I just want to take a moment to say thank you to the people in the audience who spoke up on behalf of this. Originally, I was one of the people that wrote and championed the original flag policy, and I wanted to make very clear that the intent and purpose was to recognize, celebrate, and honor groups in our community. And while historically the first time we did this was for the LGBT community for Pride Month, it's been such an honor that we've been had an opportunity to make sure that we did it for Black History Month in the past, for Juneteenth, for each of our military birthdays, for military families. And I think it's so important to articulate that because diversity truly is the foundation of our community. And I think that the failure to continue to engage in this service and celebration and honoring would be a disservice not only to the Black community, but to the City of Tracy community, because ultimately we need to remember that the Black community is the Tracy community. The Black history is American history. And I would be remiss if I didn't take a moment to recognize that when this city raised a flag for the first time on the 50th anniversary of Stonewall, it was because people of color stood up for the LGBT community, specifically Black women stood up for the LGBT community. And just as on that day, I think it's important, very important that we stand in solidarity. And with that, I absolutely will be in support of this measure. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other comments? Mayor Pro Tem?
Thank you, Mayor. I do want to thank everybody for coming out and sharing your sentiments regarding the flag, raising of the Black flag. For the month of February. Although I have not supported this policy in the past, I've always held that my opposition has been to the policy and not the people. Obviously, as a Black woman, I could never be in opposition of myself and my own people. But I've had the pleasure of speaking with the mayor recently, and we spoke about resetting and about being open to other perspectives. And in this case, I don't want my perspectives on policy to be a divisive issue when I support my people. And this is my attempt at building consensus with a community and a council who wants to see this flag raised because of the flag. And you guys don't care about the policy. So we're gonna have to figure out a way to get the policy adjusted while still honoring the request. And so representation is important. It's important to me as a Black woman. Diversity, equity, and inclusion is important to our community. And it's important to me that all members of our community feel represented, feel safe, welcomed, and embraced by the policies that we set forth. And Evelyn Tolbert mentored me as well. And I know that I stand on her shoulders. I recognize that. And so it's my intent to lean on the things that I've learned from her and the things that I'm learning from our community and the privilege of serving on this council. And as a show of support for the intentions of our mayor, the former council, and the council body, acknowledging those of us who are of African American descent and those who support us and our contributions to not just the city of Tracy, but to the United States and globally, as well as to acknowledge that precedent has already been set by the previous raising of this and other flags, and to try to honor that Mayor Young did previously request that the Pan-African flag be displayed annually for Black History Month, along with the other flags, and that it was inadvertently left off the list. For those reasons, I will be supporting this item, but will also be asking council to come back so that we can clean up this policy, because I believe it needs to be a community-led policy that more readily allows for other groups to have fair access to equitable representation. The LGBTQ community has it, the Black community, we have it, but I like to see the Latino, the Asian, the Muslim, and so on also have access to this representation. So it's within this council's ability to ensure this kind of equitable representation is in reach for all citizens of Tracy. And so with that, that's my comments, Mayor. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor Pro Tem. Councilmember. Councilmember Dola.
Thank you, Mayor. I'll be brief. I just want to go on the record, if my council colleagues will allow me. For me, this is an easy yes, as it was in 2021. but I do want to, please, let's hold our applause, right? But I do want to go on the record that I do disagree with the characterizations or attacks that were made towards city staff. But I will be supporting this. Let's vote.
Any other comments?
Thank you, Mayor. Yes, I'll make some comments. So I will be supporting 2A. I'll be supporting all three parts, 1, 2, and 3. I'm a big believer in the doctrine of Martin Luther King Jr. His was a vision of unity, and I do believe that this flag is in alignment with that vision of unity. I agree with Mayor Pro Tem Davis. I do believe there is work to be done on this policy. I believe it can be more fair for our residents. But while I'm in this seat and while that policy is in place, I will work to ensure that we approve responsible flags that are representative of this community. I believe that this flag checks both of those boxes. So looking forward to seeing it raised.
Thank you. So I'd like to make my brief comments before. I just want to really just thank the community for coming out. This is really a display really of unity for everyone here to be able to speak out about equity and equality. And we know that there are two different things, but we want to look at that and how it affects our entire community. So I truly appreciate all of your continued support, because many people will speak out or like email or text or whatever, but to actually come and show your support of this item, and I really appreciate it. And I'm grateful for a council that is open to be able to be forward thinking and, as the last speaker said, creating this movement as we continue to move forward. And there is room for looking at our policy for what we're going to do going forward, because we want to make sure that everybody that's a part of our community feel like they're a part of our community. So with that, roll call, please.
Councilmember Doya?
Yes.
Mayor Pro Tem Davis?
Yes.
Councilmember Areola?
Yes.
Councilmember Evans?
Yes.
And Mary Young?
Yes. Thank you. The item passes, and so I know Councilmember Badola needs to leave, and I just want to make sure that as a part of this, because what we did approve was the ceremony, so on coming, because I know you're going to leave, and we're doing our council items, but on Wednesday, February 1st, 2 days from now, we will be raising the flag at the end of the ceremony that will begin at 10 o'clock a.m. It will be held inside the lobby, as the mornings are very, very cold outside, so you all are invited to come. All right? Thank you. And so with that, we will go on to, I'm sorry, I just wanted to make note, because we did get an email that's on our dais, but it was by someone who spoke over the phone by Mr. Silva in support of this item as well. Okay, so with that, you may quietly leave as we get ready to finish up our agenda for this evening. Sorry, I'm trying to get back to my notes. This takes us to council items and comments. We had our council items from Councilmember Badola as he had to leave. And so, Mayor Pro Tem, do you have any?
No, thank you, Mayor.
Thank you. And do you have any, Councilmember Evans?
Yes, Mayor. Last Friday, Pro Tem Davis and myself went to visit the temporary homeless shelter.
If you want to wait till it's more quiet, it's fine.
It's okay.
It's up to you.
We went to visit the shelter and came back with a few bulletized items. There's the 8 new portable shelters that are on site. They've been there for a number of weeks now. Each have 4 bedrooms in them, so potentially 32 rooms available. So also, day before, went to El Pescadero Park, counted about, it's hard to count, but approximately 30 tents. So by my math, it should be about the right number of rooms to get that park cleaned up pretty well. So came back with a list of some items that are remaining to get those units opened and houseable. And I drafted a letter, went to City Manager Rogers on Friday. So hopefully those items are being worked on, along with the request that we get, City Council receives an ongoing report from staff every week on all the critical items to get those units into shape so that they can actually be used as housing. So my hope is, with my project management background, that we can keep these things moving forward. There's a lot of potential out there, but we're still on multiple gas generators. I was lucky enough to be there when they were being fueled. We're burning, by my math, about 150 gallons a day of diesel. So there's about approximately 500 gallons of diesel on site at any given time.
Excuse me,
environmental catastrophe.
I'm sorry, can I pause for one
moment?
Excuse me, gentlemen, we are still having a meeting right now. Gentlemen? Okay, Pastor James, Mr. Bivin, Pastor Young, if you can all, thank you. You can step outside.
Thank you, Mayor. So we've got a big environmental risk on site. Another storm event happens. You know, I'm concerned. We've got a possibility of getting electricity out there. City manager is in receipt of a company that I know that can get power on site, I believe, temporary power in expedited fashion. We need to get that done. So I'm looking very much forward to staff report on getting these items checked off and done so we can get the unhoused housed in El Pescadero Park, get that park cleaned up for our kids, and move the city forward. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other? It was something that I totally forgot what I was going to say. Should have wrote that down. Oh, our next meeting. I'll write it up. I have a lot that I wrote down for the U.S. Mayor's Conference. And so if you follow me on social media, then you saw all the updates on there, the little mini updates. But I have a lot more. I'll just go ahead and present in writing and give it next time, because our next meeting will be on February the 7th, 2023, which is next Tuesday. And for 10 years of being on the council, I have not been here in person. I've always been here in person. And our last regular council meeting was ran by our Mayor Pro Tem, who did a great job. And so our next council meeting will be ran by Mayor Pro Tem because my son is getting married in Cancun, and so I will be there. I will log on, provided the internet is not too sketchy. I will log on and be a part of the meeting as well, but I just want to let you know in advance and happy coming up wedding for son, Benjamin, and so I will leave it into the trusted hands of our Mayor Pro Tem Davis.
Thank you.
For the next week, which will be my daughter's birthday, so I'll say happy birthday in advance for her too. Lydia will be 26. I can't believe everybody's grown up, but those are all my comments. So with that, we will move for adjournment tonight.
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Seconded.
Okay, it was moved by Mayor Pro Tem Davis, seconded by Councilmember Areola. Roll call, please.
Mayor Pro Tem Davis?
Yes.
Councilmember Areola?
Yes.
Councilmember Doya? Councilmember Evans?
Yes.
And Mayor Young?
Yes. Good night. Thank you.